to draw your character with at least 6 emotions. And you can just reuse the same head again and again if you want. That's what I'm going to do here. And I'm going to give you some options for you to help you out with this. So now if I start with just like regular eyes, you know, that's just regular eyes. I'm not using an Apple pencil. I'm using, it kind of looks like Rick and Morty since I'm not using an Apple pencil. It's all jiggly. So I get standard eyes. And notice the eyebrows are just like a little bit above the eyes. And you can turn it into like, but just by raising the eyebrows up and making the eyes a little bit bigger, you can give it surprisey eyes. So surprisey eyes would be like bigger eyes, eyebrows higher up. And then it just looks more surprised if you draw the eyes bigger. Notice that the pupils don't get any bigger, just the actual shape of the eye. And you can pair this with a little ooh, which is just, you know, it's a tight little circle and a U there, and it's pretty surprising. Now, if you're surprising, you don't want to go like that unless the person's like shocked, like, ah! But by making the eyes really big and raising the eyebrows up, then you can really kind of get that surprising thing look there. Now, I believe we talked about in our Zoom, you can also cut off the top of the eyes to draw that angry eyes. And this works best if you also cut off part of the pupil. So you definitely want to cut off the pupil as you cut off the top of the eye, like so. Now, where's the eyebrow, you might be asking? Well, you could make this line a little bit thicker, make this the eyebrow, or you can just kind of draw the eyebrow like that, like just barely above the eye, because that's what happens with angry eyes. The eyebrow is just barely above the eye. And you can put like a little butt there between the two to make it look like they're kind of being pushed together. And then you've also got, of course, you know, sweet eyes like this, in which the eyebrows are angled up. You just kind of cut off the top of the eye. Again, you want to cut off part of the pupil as you do this. And then the eyebrows actually kind of look like look like the letter U a little bit as they go up. If you want, you could even kind of add some like little lines for the forehead wrinkling. Mm. And this can be paired with any of those mouths. Any of these eyes can be paired with any of the mouths, actually. And if the person's like amazed, then that's when it's fun just to draw the pupil huge and just add like all kinds of cool reflections. By the way, to get a good white in Procreate, you always want to, yeah, I get up there, but a lot of times I don't have like a really good white, and you got to make sure that this little bottom thing slid all the way to the right. A lot of times I'll get like a really light gray. So if you're in disk mode, especially important, it's really hard to get like a good white if you're in disk mode. But if you go to classic, then you can get a little bit better. Just make sure that it's all the way to the right. Anyways, and then I can add, you know, a whole bunch of like reflections and stuff. Maybe some like really big ones and some smaller ones. I think this, maybe I'll add like a little, and so then it's like, whoa, I think this one looks a lot better than the other one. But you get the idea. If they're amazed in their eye, their pupils get huge. That might look cool too with the little, ooh, wow. I guess it could work with the, wow, like a huge mouth. And I think eyebrows up high would be pretty cool for that one. But definitely play with the eyebrows. If they're up high or down low, that definitely matters. Because, you know, my favorite expression is the look, in which one of the eyebrows is up high and the other one is kind of cutting off the top of the eye. That's, I think, my favorite expression. Then the character's like, I don't know about that. But, or it can be the, ooh, what? Or you can go with like the angry face, which I'm going to show you in just a minute. Then I mean, that's like a pretty interesting expression. I don't know what that is, but it's specific. I guess it's kind of like really frustrated. All right, now speaking of mouths, we got all kinds of different options. You got like just plain old regular mouth and just like, hey, I'm happy. And this is a good all-purpose talking mouth, but what I want you to notice about these two mouths right here is that there's a little bit of a dangly overlap there on the edge. And here's how that works. Let me erase this. If the head is pointing this way, which it is, then you want to start here and then loop it around so that there's like a little dangly leftover. So you don't go all the way to the start of your line. Instead, you just leave a little bit left over. And what that looks like is kind of like a realistic version of what the mouth would actually do, which would be this, if it was actually pointing to the side. And see how like the lip just kind of goes over the edge there a little bit? That's disgusting looking. Anyways, so you can simulate that by just having a little bit left over there. And if you have a nose, you could even kind of connect the edge of it like that. Let me try again. And it's totally like SpongeBob. And you could, like SpongeBob, except has like a big old dangly leftover. But the point is, if you have a slight leftover, then it looks cool. Calvin from Calvin and Hobbes, that's the way they do his mouth like that too, and lots of characters. So try to have a little dangly leftover. Now, if you're trying to draw like a really angry mouth, then I would recommend a trapezoid. But then draw two black triangles in the side. And you want to make sure if they're super angry, then you're actually sticking out your bottom jaw. And you can show that by making the top teeth overlap the bottom teeth. So I just draw like the gums and the teeth. And then it's just like, ah. And since it's all cartoony, you can kind of connect them. But again, make sure the bottom teeth overlap the top and they look really angry. So let's see here. But you compare any of these mouths with any of these eyes and it's pretty cool looking. And this works with any eye, by the way. So for example, if I wanted to make like confused eyes with eyes that just look like, well, something like this, you could still do that. Just raise up the eyebrow, cut off the top, and there you go. So it still works no matter what kind of eyes you have. I don't know. Ugh. Works so much better if you draw the mouth starting with the top. It just kind of goes a lot smoother. I like to draw the top teeth, but not the bottom teeth. That kind of meshes with what really eyes look like. And don't forget that you want the darkest part of your character to be, well, the eye will go to wherever, like the reader's eyes will go to whatever is the darkest areas. So you want the darkest areas to be the eyes and sometimes the mouth. But if you give your character like a big black bow tie, but then you use like really light eyes, then the character is gonna be drawn more to like the bow tie in the eye, the bow tie in the mouth than the eye. So make sure you make your eyes nice and dark. All right, I think that's it. So your assignment is to draw your character with 6 emotions. And like I said, you can just reuse the same head shape each time. That is totally fine. And you might be able to come up with some expressions that I didn't come up with. So good luck, have fun, and I look forward to seeing your character drawn with 6 expressions. Cool. Oh, you probably also want to be copying and pasting your head so you can do it again and again. So in this case, I would just kind of copy the head again and again. So keep in mind, there you go. Point is, 6 heads, handle it however you want, 6 different emotions. All right, bye.